Good morning. It is September 13, 2020. This is Present Lifestyle Today, compiled with Organic Lifestyle Today. This is a good morning broadcast radio hour with Laurel Sobol as your host. We are in unprecedented times. At least enough to be unprecedented enough of civilizations having come and gone. But study the book of Enoch, his dreams and visions and places he went, and the book of Enoch and his grandson Noah. Please research these books and the times and what was going on. The time of censorship will not end. It is up to our scholars and wise people to gain knowledge of their own accord the best way they can and impart that wisdom. That is a blessing because the person who hides the real news has the real news and can manipulate great sums of people and thwart reality and history. It is the very young and the elders who are especially at risk from fake censored ideologies and philanthropists. And right now, in this revelation, the induced labors of man-made apocalyptic star geo-weather warfare is desecrating our Heavenly Father's of earth, heaven, and all it is, his creation. We're going to enjoy some natural colors to help restore the soul. Most of these are North Rockies in the Banff National Park. This is what we are up against. It is called a multi-layered and tiered storm. We are still celebrating our moment, but we are praying. And this is what our Heavenly Father is up against. There are missiles and there are UFO speed of light and faster aircraft that are manned by people. NASA and ISS. This is a shot from NASA. Obviously, they've got satellites that they obviously utilize. And this is a multi-leveled attack. The air quality hasn't been this bad or measured to be this bad ever. In the 700 level of hazardous air quality. As you can see, it is like a hurricane. As you can see where the initial bombs were deployed and where the target area is moving. And if you research that, it probably is going to fit right alongside the high rail speed system and the super dams that they want for their super toxic railroads and Monsanto crops that they plan on using the fields of the Willamette Valley to make the people of the world and the animals in the world more toxic and sick. I am in the midst of all of this with my family, and we've had to evacuate. We are now presently at our home, which is on the outskirts of this, somewhere close. And this is in the Cascades area of Oregon. They are burning up the forest. They're burning up people in their homes. And this is going up and down the West Coast. How do we celebrate our moment? where we unite ever closer with our Father of heaven and earth, and we nestle in to his love and his wisdom, and we impart that to ourselves, our family and friends, and our community and the world to make the world a better place and stop this insanity. I could name names, but we pretty much know the names. They're people who have great money at stake. No money can replace all the trees and herbs and medicine in the forests around the world that they're desecrating. And then everything goes up. So people are joining up and they're having to have like 10 families in one house just to survive. And our youth have no jobs. And the government's bankrupt. And they don't help people. The only people in the government who help anybody is themselves, with lame, retarded answers, stupidity, ignorance. And if you thought it was bad during the Obama years, well, it's worse. The calibration and level of people operating this taxpayer jobs, paying for the public servants that are being paid by the taxpayers around the world, are ignoramus, suck up to evil minded people, and what do you call it? Just horrible people operating. This is warfare. You can see where the missiles dropped, and it's a clear disaster. Normally they would do clear cuts, which is really retarded. Clear cutting has no place. It's just stupid. It sets the ground ready for loggers to just come in. And this sets the stage for logging, of course, because once the Feinsteins and all of Congress and the Senate and the House get their millions from catering and being complicit and complacent with and part of the man-made apocalyptic warfare, they're gleaning all the assets that come, the money for relief, the emergency toxic food, the emergency toxic supplies, the emergency toxic medicines, the whole thing, the emergency money that just goes toward Resilient Cities 100, which propagates the very thing you are seeing here. It feeds these disasters, and it feeds the people who are like Rockefellers and Feinsteins, Pelosi, her nephew and governor of California, Newsom, Kate Brown. You name it, these people all have a sinister agenda, okay? And their goons, NASA and ISS, keep on smiling your silly, goofy grins, guys, because we know what you're doing up there. You're helping these people, and we are reflecting on our present. We are breathing deeply. Even though the gas is almost killing us from the fires you're imparting on us, my throat is burning up. It's parched from the smoke from days and days. It's been almost a week. But it's still autumn in Banff here of the High Lakes. And they've been through fire too. This is from this morning. Jesus said it would be difficult for people to get to heaven, and then they ridiculed him and insulted him and humiliated him and said, oh no, that can't be true. It can't be true. And he said, well, maybe it won't be true. Maybe you'll be able to get into heaven, but he knows that they won't. Not for a very long time. This is our present. This is high Rockies area, the Colorado zone, the north of Utah zone, in the Rockies in America. and they are using prisms and harp technologies that aren't just based in Alaska. No, they're all sizes, shapes. There's all levels of satellites. Thank you, Elon Musk and associates preceding him and that follow him. Look at that giant prism shape around the sun. Can you see that? That makes our sun it amplifies the intensity of the sun, and it can also, these war crimes can cause devastating cold and devastating heat. They have been saying global warming and this, that. Well, yeah, they created it. It can stop on a dime. It can be turned around. There's animals that aren't getting water, from the microbiology up to the highest animals on the food chain and in life. They're being deprived water because it's being manipulated to kill, crush, and destroy by the agenda of, it used to be a modest amount of people. But actually, we are like in the times of Enoch and Noah, where the vast amount of majority of people are actually not good. Sorry, you're not good. I wish you were. But in those days, before the flood, and there was a flood, the people were just they were beguiled by their own insipidity, their own ignorance, and the ignorance of the people who were the rulers and guiding the people. And everybody was complicit and complacent in all kinds of awful behaviors that were total anti-wisdoms of Yashua. And so people can smile their little knowing smile, like NASA and ISS people. You can all look at each other and say, yeah, we all know how bad we alls are. Let's just keep on being all bad, y'all. Let's just keep on being criminals and let the criminals keep being worse criminals. Who cares if the world crumbles around us? We'll sneak into heaven anyway and get the riches we deserve there. This is the riches that we deserve right here on this earth. The sun and the moon. The beautiful earth and the ocean, the sky and the flowers and the bees and the butterflies and family and friends. This is heaven on earth. Do you think that Yashua wants the people who want the destruction to infiltrate the earth anymore, or his heavenly areas? Beyond our realm of ability to see that heaven on the other side of when we're alive, where our spirit goes and where he takes us, where moves us, transports us. Can you imagine the intensity of the coyotes and bears that live out in the area and any wolves that might happen that should be there naturally? And the bison that should be just flowing like the wind through the prairie grasses around these high plateaus. But no, people aren't hardly allowed up there. They can hardly get there because of the cost of money to get there. These lands need to be returned to the Native Americans and loved and protected. That's right. Sheltered and honored. These power stations and super satellite transmitters and receivers with their prism warfare and other equipment lodged in them and usable with other tons of equipment that the the sinners are using need to be stripped. They need to come out of our national parks, out of nature. The cell towers need to come down. The mind games and the MK Ultra needs to be disbanded. The great ear and the great giant space orbs and cities out in space need to come out of space, need to get down out of there. Stop spying on people and killing us, shooting us in the back with your fires and your lasers and your chemtrail bombs, and you're destroying whole countries and whole world. Right here in this beautiful, peaceful moment. Almost daily, it's called On the Way to the Sun. It's one of the names. It's an energy that is not natural, is being forced on this area, which is potent with energy and incredible forces of nature right here, right without them intensifying it in any way, nor sucking out of it, nor pulling the energy out of these. It's a super volcano area, all in this area. And this is from this morning too. Intense beams of energy downloading and uploading, and to manipulate the storms and the fires on the West Coast and anywhere else they are, as well as every other system of device that is swinging around the world and hitting people, hitting them senseless and into death and disease and death, and all the animals who know not. This little cow is in the St. Mary's Glaciers National Park area, where buffalo should be roaming, not that little guy. It's probably a Rockefeller cow. They've been usurped. They've usurped the land with their cattle, and they've taken our buffalo away. If a buffalo actually got that far out of Yellowstone, it would have been killed about one step out of the park. As you can see, there's not enough room for the buffalo because, why? The cow needs more room. Now, I love cows. I'm sorry for every hamburger I ever ate. But I do love cows, and I have had buffalo meat, and it is the best. And when I have buffalo, it's a sacred meal. And I am an indigenous people, adopted by the heart of the Nez Perce people in 1987. These lands need to go back. They have been usurped. They say we people have destroyed the parks and aren't allowed, but the people who are destroying it are the very people saying that other people are destroying it. This is a reminder. I'm really happy to announce that I have some books that sold that are really cool. People will be very happy with these books. There's a seascape journal called Southern Oregon Paradise. All of the books help support my work to keep going, and my nervous energy from being an MK Ultra targeted individual, the creativity to draw and paint and be creative and put art and books and movies together and become one of the world's greatest educators in the world that ever was, all because of the grace of our Heavenly Father, Yashua. Thank you, Elohim. B'nai Kodesh. The holidays are upon us very soon. And the deliveries of books and items might be a little delayed. So be sure to get your Christmas and your Hanukkah orders in as soon as possible. This is a special present moment. not only present because Hanukkah and a lot of holidays around the world, there's gift-giving exchanges. But not only for these gift-giving exchange times, but when people are, it seems to me that it's trending that staying at home is going to become very popular the next long time in history. Because the country and the world has been bankrupted because of the man-made apocalyptic Star Wars that is at hand, and they need a lot of money to finance their evil. While they're doing that, and while they will hopefully be usurped and decent people take over, what they're doing, not to do more bad, but to turn it around for it to be doing good, if there is good to be had of any of that, letting nature take its course, letting nature have natural rain and natural weather is important. Vast areas in the world have no water and haven't had no water for up to a decade or more. Easter Island effect. Basically, nothing growing is what happens as a result. And forcing people into tight, knotted areas so that they can become easier target victims. In smart cities and resilient cities, 100 just makes the world worse. And then croplands will be loaded with toxins from Monsanto, Bayer, Blackwater Assassin groups and affiliates, DuPont, BASF, and the list goes on and on. But here we have Southern Oregon Paradise. It's a lovely painting that I did of the beach. It has seaweed and gentle waves, pines on the bluffs above the sea. And it's an incredible painting. Archangel Michael, Defender of God, another beautiful book. Two wandering albatrosses make a difference in the world. And that is a fairy tale filled with education. It is a tool that is a whole education in itself. And the book has so many incredible facts and geological accurate accounts and information that it's a treasure trove. In fact, all of the fairy tales are treasure troves and worthy of the finest home school or school experience for all ages. So we have Swan's Purple Mist. And I believe that's a journal. Caves of Topanga Canyon. Mysteries of Topanga. It's a mystery of Topanga. It's kind of my take on a similar story like Laura Ingalls Wilder on Little House on the Prairie. My story is called Mysteries of Topanga. And also my whole series, all of my books and all of my works, is part of Little House of Miracles, particularly the stories and movies. And they're genuine, made with love, and none of my work is like 100% perfect. Because perfection, I believe, belongs to Yeshua. He is perfect. I am not perfect, but he is. Caves of Topanga Canyon. Yeah, that's a very popular one, and people are interested in that one. It's very interesting, but all of the Mysteries of Topanga stories are really cool. And the heirloom collections are fantastic. These are, again, great learning tools. Insightful about the area and the nature and people and family and interactions and what's going on. And journals go with these books because people can get their own creative ideas going and their own books going, their own journals, or just keep start collections of stories and fairy tales or just information like the nature series or national park series or organic lifestyle today series or just the list goes on. Two wandering albatross collection and two polar bears travel the world collection. Each one of these books is like a chapter book, or you can buy the whole story in one book. And then there's a trilogy of books and fairy tales and little fawn fairy tale and how honeybee fairy tale, sleepy time in the woods, sleepy time in the big woods, and that's also in movies. And also you can read it to classical music in the background. How Bear Lost His Tail, a Nez Perce legend. Nez Perce Nimipu Stories and Legends. That's going to have quite a few. The more recent the book, the more it will probably have of stories added to it. The Gospel of St. Thomas. Nez Perce Nimipu Stories and Legends. Crater Lake National Park. Again, place your orders around now, and also think of educating yourself. At the holidays, I like to get my family my books because I don't know of any finer books to get them. And this year I ordered my books, and I also, of course, have to get myself an edition because I just love my books so much. And Enoch is going to be the star of Christmas around here because I want my family to have that book. I hope they will one day read it and open it, but if they'll have it, and hopefully they'll read passages, and when they're ready, read the whole thing, if that happens. Hopefully they'll read it over and over. Try to do your exercise daily. Exercise is really important in our present. Focus on your body and how beautiful you are inside out. Focus on like just cleaning the house or dusting. Try to get some energy. Here it's hard to get energy. It's hard to get energy here because it's hard to breathe. It's the air is so bad. But again, like Australia practically burns to a nubbin every year. And here they're trying to do it worse and worse. You know, I used to say, if you don't care about someone in the world getting inflicted these war crimes, it's going to get closer to home. And you'll be feeling it. If you don't reach out to the people around the world, you'll be feeling it too. And I think people have been paying attention and caring more and more about people around the world. But those people around the world need to care about others too around the world. Together we can all care about each other around the world and safeguard against these heinous crimes against our Creator Himself. Can you imagine how this saddens our Creator? Today is the Sabbath, B'nai Kodesh. It's a day to celebrate our Maker. Signing out for today. Take care. God bless you.